Okay, so we will make a project demo, and the source code for this project is available on this link on GitHub. I will create a new project for this to dive in some code, so you'll see what is the thought flow, but the final one should be in this link. So we'll work with the database, which is a very simple one with three tables, which is called student database. And there are only three tables there: a star with several fields like this, a cohort of students, and the students over here. Okay, and the SQL code for this database is uploaded on the GitHub, and it is in the BO or business object package. Next, here is the general steps of how to create a new Java application. So you'll just click on new, open NetBeans, click on new project, and you select Java, choose Java application, click next. Next, which is very important step, so we need to add a library into our system. So if you want to add existing library in your newly created project, just right click on library, click on add library, then select MySQL JDBC driver, because we want to work with MySQL in this time. Then click add library. In case there you don't have your MySQL driver yet, you can go to this link and download it. Then you choose platform independent, then click on download. After downloading, remember to extract the file. After extracting that file into this folder, let's say, look for the jar file. Again, the jar file, not zip file. And remember this folder. The next one, we follow the same step. Right click on libraries, then click on add jar folder. Then browse to the jar file that you extracted, then click on open. Now, the project structures that we will create include the following packages. The first one is BO packages, including the classes representing your business object, including the star, the student, and the cohorts. Okay, star, student, cohort. Now, the DAO here will include the Java classes that help you to work with the database. And the main or default package here will include classes to store forms or interface in general. Utilities here is going to have some helper classes. Okay. Now, here is a generic steps for you to create a new Java class. So the first one is you're going to right click on the package that you would like to add Java class in, then click on new. Then select Java class if it is there already by default. If it is not there, you can just click on others, then select Java, then you choose Java class. Click next, insert the name, and follow. Next one is a general step for you to create a new frames or new interface components. Normally it is inside your default package. So you're going to right click on it, click on new, then if you see the form is there, you'll just, let's say, choose JFrame form or JInternal frame form. But if you don't see them there, again, click on others. We're going to work with swing. So when you swing GUI forms, then select the form that you need, then click next. Okay. So for our project, we will have utilities class, but then I will work with that later. Let me go to the codes and demonstrate the steps that we learned just now. So here, okay, so I'm going to create a new Java application. Next, you have DBMS videos. Okay, finish. Okay, let me just close all the others. Those all the DBMS videos. Then for this one, we was designing. Here is the default package in which I will store the interfaces first. But then I will create a new package. That one is for a BO business object. Okay. The another one is just right click on this one, new Java package. If you don't see them, there's just browse through and this will be there, new Java package. And you'll see next one is data accept object for the second package. Then we should have the third one. This one is Java package as well. This one should have utils for utilities. Okay, so those are the packages. Next one for the library, if you would like to add the library, first you can right click on this, add library, okay, and browse to the library that you would like to have, like MySQL JDBC Driver here if it's already there. Otherwise, you can just download each one and you add Java folder, click on that. Then you're going to browse to the extracted folder that you have over there. Then you're going to select the Java file, click on open. Right now you have your JDBC installed. You have your project structures ready. And we are about to go to several of the classes in the next video.